Got another, so we'll just take it between them and go for it.
It's turned on.
It's turned on, so we're live right now?
Yep.
Live from Charlestown, Indiana, coming to you from the North Charlestown Church of God. Let's do this my way since I'm running the show. Bow your heads, let's open with prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity and this time to be here in your house, to celebrate your name, to celebrate your love, and to celebrate the life that you give us. We thank you, Father, asking your blessings on the words, on the songs, that you will be pleased by all we do. Watch over us. Bless those, Lord, on our heart that we pray for continually. We ask you to lift them up, to make them whole, to save their souls. Guide us. Keep us safe. Forgive us, Lord, when we stumble. And we thank you, Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. All right, stand up, everybody, and we're going to sing something.
361.
Thank you. God, keep me together. 361, 361. I know what the book says, but it's at the cross. Okay? The book calls it the first line. Ready when you are, Bill. Favorite by far. Now I know it's got a bunch of verses, But I'm going to stick to 1, 2, 3, and 6. And I don't normally do that. Normally I sing the whole song. But we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and 6. That's what everybody in the whole free world knows generally. And then I'm sure we'll be praising the Lord at the end.
Amen.
Just a hint, right? Okay, 125, Bill.
Yeah.
Anybody got a testimony tonight, something good the Lord's did for you you'd like to share tonight before we get started?
Yeah, he got me to church.
That was a good thing today.
Sure. It was rough, thank you. I was sick last night and during the night and this morning, and I made myself go in over next door here to be with Wayne and them to help them out, and when that was over, that was all I could do. I went home, went back to bed, and slept till not much before church time, to tell you the truth. So I'm getting there. I feel rough, but I praise God that He's there for us. As long as we've got these bodies, it's going to happen. It's a little reminder I was reading in a paper, the one I give you. You know, it's a good thing to have these things happen. Because for some reason, when we're feeling great, we forget the Lord. When we're feeling fantastic, we don't praise Him near as good as when He's just done something, brought something through for us, helped us through something, helping us up, bringing us through. Our relationship gets tight with God, and for some reason, when things are fantastic, and you're on the mountain, you don't remember Him so much. So it's good to have these little slaps in the back of the head once in a while to remind you that He's there and He cares.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand. Anybody else tonight, something good to the Lord? Yes, Serena?
This week I celebrated 6 years of leading youth ministry here, and I want to thank God for His calling. I also want to thank my church family and for the spiritual mentors, whether they're still here in heaven, who led me to this point. It was a blessing to have a student come who's Wednesday night, who's been through a lot of stuff in his young life, and it was a blessing to have conversations with him. And even some of the students this week have reached out, you know. So I just want to thank God that, you know, for His mercy and grace and for giving me a pastor that I feel comfortable, you know, being led by and fed by and all that. So that's my testimony. So there you go.
I would like to thank you tonight. I want to tell you, I want to thank God for you people. I want to thank God for this church. I was looking, and Junior had told me about Steve and them singing on the square. I was down in the park sat Saturday about 4 weeks ago or so before I started here. I heard them up there singing, and it just so happened when I was pulling in, they were singing the same song that I was singing on the radio. You know, my God, Brother David, it's been so good.
Amen.
And, you know, I've got food on my table. When I pulled up, that's what they was, shoes on my feet.
Yeah.
I've got a little bitty place where I stay, but you know what? It's a roof over my head.
That's right.
But I thank God that my buddy told me to go down there and listen for him and play with him. And I hear it's a good bunch of group of people. Pastor knows what I'm talking about, my buddy Jimmy Middleton. But anyway, I just thank God because, you know, two times that I've asked for prayer, I definitely felt the last Sunday night was from Brother Dave. The pastor laid hands on me and I felt good. And then again Thursday, things started acting up. Everybody keeps saying, go to the hospital, go to the hospital. I said, you know, I know I aren't too, I probably aren't too, but I just don't like being stuck because they had to, they messed my arm up the last time they did it and they hit the nerve. But, you know, God knows all about it. At least it ain't messed up where I can't play my guitar.
Amen.
This is my pride and joy. And you guys letting me get up here and play with you guys and sing and share some of the new music that God has given me, that He's blessed me with. At times He's woke me up at 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning and give me beautiful songs, you know. But the one I've got, my God is so good to me. I was sitting out at 7:30 in the morning on Water Street, just sitting there, oh God, you're so good to me. You're so good to me. I said, wait just a minute. That's a song. And I just thank God with that. I thank God that He uses me to pass the word to people. My friend tells me that I don't know no strangers, and I don't know. Tell anybody and everybody about God. The other day I pulled up to a Circle K and this little black gentleman sitting there on the curb looked like he hadn't had a meal in a minute. And I said, oh buddy, he said, hey, I do smoke. I went that. He said, you got a smoke? He said, I'll buy it off. I guess, no, you ain't got to do that. And I gave him that. I said, something spoke to me. I said, well, just give him some money to buy him a sandwich with. He ain't eating in a while. I said, hey, old fella, old timer, come here for a minute. I called him over there and I said, here, buddy, I said, you take this $6 here or whatever. I said, if you need more, you let me know. And go get yourself a sandwich and get yourself meat. He said, buddy, I sure appreciate it. He said, I'm a little hungry. I said, I know God showed me. I said, God bless you. Wish I could do more, you know. And I've done that before, brother, and within an hour of what God told me to do, that's when I was driving the truck. I would have a dispatcher call, hey, can you do this? I'll just send you a $50 comm check for giving somebody $5 for a little meal. You know, that ain't what it means to me, brother. I don't care if I don't get nothing back. Anybody knows me knows that. I don't ask for it back. If I give it to you, you know, I figured you needed it because God told me to give it to you. But I just thank God for this church. I really do, brother. I was looking when I got up here, and I left the Okeechobee Church of God down in Okeechobee. I was lost when I went up in the mountains. I didn't have no. There was, they don't have much church up in, way up in those mountains up in Washington, way up there towards God. And I said I'd get close, but I just thank Him. I just wanted to thank Him for the church. Thank Amen. You people. Thank you for welcoming me to your home, Amen. To your church.
Give the Lord a hand. Anybody else tonight? We've got the brother and sister Kings is getting ready to leave on us next week. We're going to miss them, and we appreciate the times that they've been here with us. And let's give them a hand for the time that they've had. Sorry to see you go, but I know you got things to do, and look forward to perhaps you crossing our paths again sometime. So, as one lady used to pass out the things, if you meet me and forget me, you've lost nothing. But if you meet Jesus and you've lost Him, or forget Him, you've lost everything. So that's the main thing about all of us. So. Anyway, that's the greatest. But I was listening to whatever radio we got in the car this morning, and the Henson. Anybody remember the Henson preacher?
Yes,
sure. And one of the brothers was testifying before he sung the song, and he said that his doctor had told him, kind of going along with what David was saying there earlier, said the doctor told him, he said, you might as well give up singing. You'll never sing again. He said, your voice is about to be gone. You're about to lose it. And he ended up just thanking God and praising God anyway. He ended up He was talking to his wife, and they started reading the book of Job. I think he went through two or three chapters. That's what I like doing. I don't like reading that whole book. I like reading the first few three chapters and the last three, two or three chapters too. But he began to read that, and God touched him. It took him a while, but he ended up the very song that you like most of all. He said, my favorite verse, 'twas grace.
Yeah.
That taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. And God touched him. And God, you know, he was singing that song on the radio this morning. I know sometimes it don't work out that way, but I know, again, God still heals, God still saves, God still delivers, and God's still on the throne, praise God. And we thank God for that, and we appreciate everything God does for us. We're going to get ready for prayer right now. And again, there's some people that Travis Barrett, they were talking about him going to Indy today, his mother was, and having some tests. And again, his heart needs a healing, or he's going to have a transplant. And praying that this medicine is helping him. Even with the medicine, he's going to have some procedure done. But if it don't help, he's going to have to be on a transplant list, and that, you know, you got to wait on it to see what happens. And then also Eddie Botkin is going to be having hand surgery in the morning tomorrow. We need to keep him in prayer. And I know Patty had asked a prayer for her daughter Katrina. I think something's going on with her also. Still praying for all those that have dealt with cancer and COVID and other health issues, as we mention on the thing every day. Praying for Steve with Smith and Company tonight, as they'll be the first time they've sung with that finest Smith tonight. Again, he went on to be with the Lord here a few, I guess it's been over a month ago now, maybe a few weeks after that. But anyway, pray for that family, especially for the wife. It'll be the first time, and she's the one that actually wanted to keep it going for his, again, in memory as well as for the glory of God. So again, still praying for Mary and Scott Young, for Samantha James. I think she is doing better. I know they said she's able to actually sit up and stand up, and so there for a while she had to stay laying down all the time. Still praying for her. It was good to see Bob and Patty go forth here this morning, but we're still lifting them up in prayer. They still need a miracle from God. And again, for David and his wife, praying for her heart, but again, for both of them to get over that. Whatever stomach sickness or whatever it is, God knows. And then again, a lot of families we're praying for. Remember next Sunday morning, the baby dedication. I think we may have a couple more possibly next week. So I know we've already got five and maybe even seven. So if any of you, and I know this is a smaller crowd tonight, but just mentioning it in case somebody hadn't heard that, we'll be doing that next Sunday morning in our services. And not baptizing babies, but we're dedicating them to the Lord. So that's what we'll be doing in part of that service next Sunday morning. So prayer request from you all. Gerald, you're good over here, and I know David.
Yeah, again, for you and your wife, get all her aches and pains straightened out too. I know what that's like when you're worried about the wife. You don't mean to worry, but you're still, I call it concern, but it's still worry. Concern over her health and how she's doing. For the ministry, wherever it is, which tonight it's at least two places I know of, here and with the Smith and Company. So that wherever the ministry is, that it'll touch hearts and that people will be drawn in.
And they're over at Ira Pyre tonight, I believe, or New Albany.
That's right, in New Albany. Yeah, down on the main road,
Absolutely.
So prayer for them, please. And the youth, if we don't get the youth in here, the church will be gone when we're gone. It's got to come up and keep refeeding, and it's the kids that's got to do that. So.
Be fruit to multiply more ways than one, huh?
Amen.
For sure. Other prayer requests? Anybody else, Wayne?
Family, friends, poor, unspoken, and for the country.
Amen to that. Amen. Other prayer requests on down through here? Michelle?
The church needs to fill up.
Amen. Amen. Serena?
I want to pray for Shaylin. She's still got some mental health going on. And also for Ava, like I mentioned this morning. For Michael Singer, for Sammy, she wants to get back in church so bad. She wants to quit cheer. And then for Josh with his job, he also wants to come back more often, but they've been working him now as a manager, so he's worried about that. And I also want to praise God for my dad because he's doing well in this new home that he's in. And yesterday he called me looking for his Bible, which I put in a special place so he wouldn't lose it, and he ended up finding it, praise the Lord. And so that tells me that he is, you know, going to read it and praying more and stuff like that. He's wanting to keep the faith that we instilled in him while he was with us. So I praise God for that, too.
Yes, amen. Give the Lord a hand for that. Dallas, did you have your hand up? What are we going to do?
For my family.
Okay. Okay. Over here, sister.
I've been having a lot of trouble with nosebleeds. Mm-hmm. And vertigo. I had an appointment Tuesday. I've already been to him once, and I'm still having a lot of trouble with that. And I also remember Gary, his heart is held really good back at him. He's having problems. So, and remember us and our mother, that the Lord would just watch over us and use us for his glory.
Other prayer requests, Lisa?
For my dad for his surgery.
Yeah. You're still, no date on that, but still looking at a heart procedure, so. And Judy Hall and Martha Roark. It was good to see Martha here this morning, too. So. Anybody else prayer requests tonight? Okay. How many with uplifted hands? Yourself or someone else? God sees those hands. As we stand tonight, if anybody'd like to be anointed for yourself or someone else, you're welcome to come down. If not, you're welcome to stay where you're at. If you want to hold hands, it's fine. If you don't, it's perfectly fine. Says where two or three are gathered in his name, he's in our midst. He's in our midst tonight, isn't he?
Amen.
I got two amens anyway, amen. So that's good. Two
amen.
Or three.
Amen.
I know there's others, but I'm just messing with you. But let's agree in
thank
prayer
you, Lord.
Tonight. Father God, we come to you tonight in the sweet name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, that God, you love us and you care for us, that you're there for us. We thank you, Lord, that again, God, you're awesome, Lord. We know that, again,
yes,
you
amen.
Care about our every need, our
amen.
Every hurt, or every pain, Lord. And I know you expect things from us, but, Lord, at the same time, we're always expecting from you all the time, Lord. And we're dependent, of course. Father God, we do pray tonight, Lord, God, for your touch upon needs of people's lives tonight. We pray, God, that, Lord, you'll touch, again, Travis Barrett tonight or today. I know he was going to Indianapolis and praying for that miracle for him, and pray that God, again, you'll touch and move upon him. For Eddie Bodkins, for that hand surgery tomorrow, that everything's going to be well with that. For those that are having procedures this week, having tests and things, we pray, God, that again, great things would come forth. We do pray for a young man that was asked to be prayed for. Mike Wentworth, I believe, was in a motorcycle wreck. I know Tom Waters had requested prayer for him. And we just pray, God, you touch him, again, for Bob and Patty, and also for her daughter, Katrina, that you'd bring forth healing. We pray for David and Melody. And again, for David, Lord, that God, you'll take that, whatever that sickness is, and lift it away from him, for his wife and for her heart as well, too. Pray for all of our families, Lord. Pray for the needs, as Serena was mentioning, the young people, Lord, for Ava and Shaitlin. We just lift them up to you in prayer that you would touch and move upon them. And again, for the young man, Michael, we pray that you'll touch him as well. And Lord, we do pray for Mary and Scott Young as they're going through some trying times. And Samantha James, we pray for her. And again, Lord, there's just a host of people. We pray for Lisa's dad, Donald, that God, you'll touch him for the procedure he's got coming, Lord, not scheduled, but coming up with his heart, Lord. And again, for Judy Hall and others, for all those dealing with that, back problems and heart issues, again, the cancer, the COVID, touch and move upon each and every one. For the hands that went up tonight, for those that are watching, listening another time, we pray for them. We pray for Smith and Company as they sang out tonight, Lord, that you'll be with them, and especially for the wife, that you'll encourage her, Lord, as her husband went on to be home with the Lord here recently. And pray that that ministry can go on, as well as all the ministries, Lord. I know Dave's asked us to continue to pray for all of them, and we need to, Lord. And God, we just pray that your power and your anointing would be upon each and every one. We pray for the family of Diane Goulet that passed away this week suddenly, Lord, as she was just in this church building this past Wednesday, Lord. We lift up that family. I know she's a Bodkins, but again, and originally, Lord, we just pray for all that family that you'd be with them and help them to sense your presence and power, Lord, and especially for Laverne, Lord, as I know she was a caretaker there for a while. And again, for all of them, Lord, be with each and every one. And again, Lord, for the baby dedication next week, I pray that God, those that are, again, bringing those children to be dedicated to the Lord, I know that the children are not the ones doing it, but it's the parents, and I pray that they will make that dedication as they dedicate them children to the Lord, that they'll do, again, as Proverbs tells us, train up a child in the ways of the Lord, and when they're old, they'll not depart, and we pray that. Again, for our country, our nation, our leaders, those in authority, be under your authorship. And again, for your touch upon all. And again, Lord, for this evening, for the singing, bless and anoint it with your power, we pray in Jesus' name. And all these needs, we ask it all in Jesus' name. And all God's children said,
amen.
Amen. And amen. You may be seated if you please. You guys will do the offering. Bobby Ashburn, would you mind helping? Let us pray over the offering tonight also. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to give to the work of the Lord. We pray your blessings upon this tonight and for those that give, for those as well that have not to give, for their needs as well. And again, may everything we do in word or deed be done all to your glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Lord.
was on his face, the thorns were on his head. That scarlet robe that was on his back was stained in crimson red. And though his eyes were on the crowd that day, he looked ahead in time. And when he was on the cross, I was on his life. For he knew me, yet he loved me. His glory made the heavens shine. I was so his mind. We were on his mind. He's in the mist. He's in the midst of the storm. He's in the valley we walk through, where two or three are gathered in his name. He'll be there too. When you feel so all alone, he'll be standing next to you. He's with us now, our Lord. He's in the midst. As you travel down life's road, he's with you every day. Every step you take, he's walked ahead of you. And every night as you lay down, angels are camping all around. Never be alone, for he is in the midst. He's in the midst of the storm. He's in the valley we walk through, where two or three are gathered in his name. He'll be there too. And when you feel so all alone, well, he will be standing next to you. He's with us now, our Lord. He's in the midst. Into the prison they were thrown, but Paul and Silas weren't alone. They knew that God was there and he would see them through. So when the walls began to shake and their chains just fell away, they cried, "Behold our Lord, for he is in the midst." He's in the midst of the storm. He's in the valley we walk through, where two are. together, and his name, he'll be there too. When you feel so all alone, he'll be standing next to you. He's with us now, our Lord, he's in the midst. Our Lord's in the midst.
Up here, and he's got a list of about 20 songs, but we'll see how many he does.
Five fifty.
Bill.
This song fits my life really well. Jesus really did clean up my soul.
My soul look up with a smile.
Yeah, you said you did. Did you change your mind?
My hearing, I didn't grant that.
That's okay.
Yes, we get it.
We're 476, standing on solid. I'm standing on solid rock. May have to kick me off a little bit, Dave.
Bill have to kick you off. He's seen it.
476, standing on the solid rock.
Yeah. Bye.
in Spanish, you can sing it in Spanish. Can we play it in English? Okay, good. We can't help you with it, sorry.
Pecador penal dulce Jesús, tan feliz para siempre será.
As you behold your list of births. There's no question. Gonna wanna see your loved one waiting for me. And when you feel you share your story with the last one, that's why I'm so proud.
When I'm talking, when I'm talking.
in my tongue when I'm talking, in my eye, and now I can say he's in the song that I'm singing. In my heart, your joy is ringing.
Guitar to me. I was looking for a 12-string, been praying about it, and God blessed me with a brand new, practically brand new guitar, so I just thank God.
And Janice, the last time you're going to get to hear singing tissue, decides to visit and come up here and see us again. Yeah. And then her husband will be singing with her, I'm sure, by then, won't he?
If I have anything to do with
it, there we go. You know for sure what you're singing or what key?
Let's try C.
Give us the key and we'll just make up the rest.
Let's try C.
C? If you want this C, Bill, it's all right. You can turn that little
one. Which one?
This one here, everybody.
One, two.
It won't matter. Over.
It will.
C.
I'm going to do one of Leon's, Mercy Walked In.
Okay.
I came to the courtroom, the judge turned my way. It looks like you're guilty.
Go ahead.
Now what do you say?
Okay, Bill.
give off. Something about that name.
Small and your fortune 10 times 10.
good Lord, bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shine.
Thank you for the time that we've had here with us singing tonight. We thank you for the good music. We thank you for the good fellowship and the love and encouragement. We just pray, God, that you'll help us continue to walk in it, to talk in it, to live in it. And I pray, God, for the needs of your children. We pray for Janice over here with her nose bleeding problem. I pray that you touch, move upon her, Lord. And again, I think she said she had an appointment coming up. Pray that that'll come out good and that'll be able to help her. Again, for David and his wife, again, Melanie, we pray, God, your touch upon him. Whatever has caused that sickness to come upon him, we pray for healing. Anyone else in here tonight going through trial and tribulation, hurts, pains, we lift each and every one up to you in prayer and pray, God, for your miracle works, work, and touch. Lord, take us home safely. Bring us back together when we can, if you tarry. And we ask all things in Jesus' name. And bless those that will be watching and listening, their needs as well. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And all God's children said once again,
amen.
And amen. Shake hands. Tell somebody you love them tonight. Come back and be with us when you can. Look forward to having you here Wednesday night if you possible. God bless.